This book is about two guys who arrived to Denmark and they're drifting slowly to the island of the European delights. So for them is to discover an absolutely foreign country, a country of the Western world. One of the guys is from India and he's fascinated with America. Another guy is from Estonia, which used to be Soviet Republic. And this is important to understand. So they are friends and they're illegal and they find themselves in a refugee camp. Well, one of them at least, he did expect something, and another one is skeptical about everything, and he is not really interested, the narrator of the novel, he's not really interested to find anything, because the only hope for him is to stay as long as possible away from his homeland. So for him, the most important is not to return, while the other wants to move around and to find something. And this is the cornerstone of the book, the friendship, the how they fight orally about what to do next. And so lots of things happen out of this because they're both of them, they're young and very daring, challenging reality. When I was in Danish camp, among those fields, wandering the roads of Denmark, I had a feeling I have a unique experience, which will probably never happen to me again, and I hope it won't happen to me again. And I do not wish anyone to experience something like this. And the more I stayed in this camp, the more I was sure I have to write down what's going on. So I was writing down. And later on, when some years passed, I came back to this story and wrote Hanuman's Journey to Lowland. And in total, when I started to write it in Russian language eventually, it took me 5 years to publish it. The whole trilogy is built this way that the first is picaresque novel, second is Bildungsroman, and the third, it's confession. It is indeed epic, and it's in this way it's related to European epic story, to picaresque novel, and to picaresque story. So it's growing out of European literature, because human beings, people, we are always people. It doesn't matter how many years passed. Well, first of all, it was Petronius, and then it was, and the latest we can take the example from French literature, Louis Ferdinand Céline, and Tropic of Cancer by Henry Miller. So these novels and the many in between, and stories, Spanish stories, they inspired me, but still, the person, a friend of mine, Hanuman, he was already made up hero. He was ready to enter the epic story. He was behaving like this. He was an embodiment of picaresque behavior, I would say. Well, it happens in the end of 90s, and it's really important to understand that in this period of time, the guy, the narrator, who leaves Estonia, for him to discover Danish lands and Danish isles, it's like to discover Western world, because he used to live in the Western, in the Eastern community, in Soviet Union. He was raised in Soviet Union. He had a Soviet education. And when he moved to Denmark, everything was strange for him, as well as for his friend, Hanuman. His Indian friend, his companion, he had military father who used to be communist in Communist Party, and the narrator, his father used to be a cop, a Soviet policeman. So they both found something in common. They both came from Eastern world and more or less Soviet world. So for them, Denmark is a kind of challenge, something to discover, something to try, and to become new, to develop themselves. to find themselves in this new world and to transform. I was pretty much influenced by James Joyce and Ulysses, of course. And the first part of the novel, it's got mimetic style. It's narration. Narration drifts. It goes off and back. It wanders. Just like characters, they also wander. They are lost in the fog. Narration is lost. So it's mimetic style, and I acquired this style from James Joyce, of course. He used it in Ulysses, and it was very important. And so is metaphors. I also used it the way James Joyce did it, and Vladimir Nabokov.